Hey YouTube, just gonna update you on my Redtail catfish. He is still alive, and I have just upgraded him to that. And look at that. Basically, long story short is, you think you're getting a RTC or Redtail catfish, I would really recommend putting sand down. They like sand. You know, they're from, I forgot where they're from, but they're from, river basins that are mostly covered in sand, you know, the bottoms. So that works out a lot better, and, actually, with my redtail catfish, as you can see, he's in there, chilling, Mr. Fury. He would actually start moving the rocks and getting quite annoyed at them, so I removed as much as I could and put down sand instead. What I did also do for him is I made this thing out of heavy-duty plexiglass, some junk that people were throwing out. The top here is actually a Mac G5, I guess it's hardware protection glass, plastic thing. I don't know what the hell it is. If you ever worked on a Mac G5 computer, you'll see like this plastic thing in there, and it's got like these little sensor pads that fit in place with these switches that are in there. I gutted one and I got this thing, and I thought, hey, wouldn't that be cool? Because it's got like this little observation looking thing, and you can look down in there and see them. And I was gonna throw it out, so I decided to do this, and everything is going quite well, and yeah, everybody's happy except for him, because he doesn't like change. He's an idiot, by the way. He is quite dumb. His name's Derp. He's a black-finned catfish. That's all he does. But the reason why I also got rid of his house is, besides being too small for him, he also, well, he and him also decided to want to move it. So they would kick out the supports and stuff like that. So this is just an easier way to do it. If you're wondering how I actually glued this stuff together, I used crazy glue, let it sit over the night, overnight, washed it out real good so there's no like dusty residue or whatever the heck it, you get to call that stuff. It's no longer there. You want to run sand on your tank. This is just an old school method. That's actually a stocking. Why I do that is because if you don't, and they kick up sand, well, it goes right into your filter. And I'm running a 100-gallon canister filter right now. See it in its glory. You can see it in the tubes. There it is. So, there it is. This method seems to work out nice. And see, with the RTC redtail catfish, they like to hide. A lot of people, I feel bad for these guys, because a lot of people just don't treat them nice. They just leave them in this big tank, or most of the time little tank, because they can't afford a big tank, with nothing. I mean, this catfish has nothing. And, you know, I'm not all touchy-feely, you know, softy, but, you know, if I was a catfish with nothing in the tank and no, you know, nothing to look at, and, I mean, these guys are pretty smart. He wouldn't actually go in this thing until I put his rock. That is his rock. He will actually nudge up against this at night and, I guess, go to sleep. Because that was in his old house. And I actually have a little light there for him, too, because he likes to look at the light. I mean, these guys are pretty smart. He's not a dumb fish. He's very smart, and, you know, I just fed him, so that's why his belly's huge. But I really think he likes this arrangement. I put some rocks in there. Just try to make it a little bit more homey. I know you can't see it. There's a rock back there. I got those rocks right there. The cichlids fight over that all the time. The problem with the cichlids, though, they kind of like to do that. They don't really mess with him that much, but he lives up the tank, and I rescued these guys. They were gonna probably die because the old people didn't know what they were doing, and they were the son's fish. Son went into the service. They didn't know what they were doing, so I rescued them. Gave a lot of them away because they breed like crazy. But yeah, that's pretty much it. And this is a, also wondering about the tank. This is a, I think it's a 1970, I don't know what the hell tank it is, but the glass on it is like intensely thick. I mean, I actually don't have any supports or anything underneath this. It's just this metal base on the sides, because, I mean, the glass is, you know, about as thick as my thumb, pretty much. So it's pretty good for him. You know, when time comes, he'll just get bigger and bigger tanks, but, you know, he's a good little boy. A girl. I don't know. There's not really a way to sex these things, if you're also wondering. There's no way. Yeah, but that's pretty much it. Go on, deer. Turn around. Says, no, I like looking at my light. They like red lights for some reason. I actually did that once just to, when I turned the lights off, to add, like, ambiance. But he would come out and stare at the tank, at the light. So, you know, he kind of enjoys it, I guess. But that's pretty much it. Little cichlid's house they never seem to use. Algae here. Why that one plant's like that is... Oh, dude, you just ate a whole entire giant shrimp. I don't know if you saw that or not. You just pulled a shrimp out of thin air and ate it. So that piece of fake thing keeps him from going in there. Because he likes to go in there, and then he gets stuck because this guy is an idiot. These guys are not known for their intelligence. I mean, he's freaking Einstein, and this guy is the special internet explorer guy with the helmet on. He's pretty dumb as fish go. I mean, these guys are smarter as they fight over a piece of shrimp. Yeah, Siri's like, I don't care, I got my light. I don't give a damn. But there she blows! A new tank. Like I said, that's a Mac G5 protection thingy with some heavy duty plexiglass and everything. Put a rock on top to make it homey for him. And he pretty much enjoys it, so. There you go, YouTube.